As always, we are going to start by making sure that our phone is powered down, and next we have two pentalobe screws adjacent to the lightning port that need to be removed. If this tutorial seems to move too fast or you don't have a lot of experience repairing phones, I recommend you check out the detailed tutorial linked in the video description. The iPhone 8 Plus opens up from left to right, something like a book. We have cables here and here that you need to watch out for on the inside, and a set of clips that go along the top that lock in underneath the housing on the frame. So we have to make sure that we slide this down slightly before we start prying it open this direction. From here, I like to apply heat. If you don't have a heat gun, you can use a hairdryer. It will help to make the adhesive slightly easier to work with. You'll need a pry tool like an iSesamo or something similar. Personally, I prefer to use a dulled razor blade as I find that it is thinner and easier to get in between the gap that we need to kind of prop open here. Once you've got it separated, it's good to go in here with something a little thinner. My personal favorite recently has been a waterproof playing card dipped in rubbing alcohol. Just going to run this along the side, pretty much around the perimeter of the phone. There is one area at the top right hand corner that you won't be able to get through, so you can go ahead and skip over that. Once you've loosened the adhesive a bit, you might find it helpful to switch over to a slightly thicker pry tool like a guitar pick. That way we can kind of create a gap that we'll be able to grab a hold of so that we can pull the display forward and slide it down from the top end. Make sure you don't skip this part. We do need to slide this down so we have a gap at the top before we open up the phone. And once everything is cleared, you can very carefully pry it open. Just remember that we do have cables on the right-hand side, so we don't want this thing to flop all the way over and put stress on those. Once you have the screen propped open, you're going to remove two Y000 tri-lobe and four PH000 Phillips screws from the retaining panels. After you get all the screws out, go ahead and remove the cover plate from the battery and display connector, and also the one that goes behind the connector for the front-facing camera. We have four connectors to disconnect. I recommend you do them in this order. The number one that you see on this image is for the battery, and we want to get that unplugged first. From there, we can unplug this cable, and if you lift it up, you'll see that there is another one that is sort of obscured from view before you disconnect it. And then, of course, we want to unplug the cable for the front-facing camera assembly. There are four Y000 tri-lobe screws that hold on a retaining panel behind the home button. Go ahead and remove those and the retaining plate itself. If your replacement part does not include the big metal panel that goes behind the LCD, you'll have to remove these six additional screws and transfer it over. Notice that five of them are Y000 and the one at the bottom right hand corner shown here is Phillips. And next we want to stabilize the lower cable while we disconnect the home button flex and it opens up over to the side. Just be careful that you don't damage anything in the process. We're now going to pry behind the cable with a playing card that has been soaked in rubbing alcohol. Be very careful, you don't want this cable to bend. The more that you keep it straight, the less chances you have of damaging anything that's on it. And of course, we want to make sure that we don't actually cut through the cable. So do make sure that you maneuver around that little peg where it sets, and from there, once it's separated, you can drop it through the front of the housing. Now, I like to transfer these over immediately, so we're going to move this cable out of the way and make sure that we slide this one underneath it, and then once you get everything lined back up and stick it down, we can plug it back in. There are five total screws at the upper end of the display. You can see on the right-hand side there, there's actually two inside of that one circle. All five of these need to be removed. Once they're out, you can go ahead and pull this retaining panel off and fold your front-facing camera over to the left-hand side to reveal the speaker, and that can come out at this point also. From here, you're going to have adhesive all over the place, so be very careful when you remove this cable. You certainly do not want to tear it, and you're going to have to get the proximity sensor out from inside of the little plastic piece on the front, and then pry behind the cable here and also along the bottom where those four gold discs are located. Again, if you want to use some alcohol, that can make this a little easier. Apply some heat as well, and that usually gets the job done. We're going to remove this small piece of double-sided tape. If this gets damaged in the process, you can always replace it, but I'm going to transfer this over to my new display so that we have something for these cables to stick on. Now go ahead and lay this back down inside. You can see there are a couple of pegs that will help you to align that area where the discs are, and then just lay everything back into the same position it was. Again, make sure that your proximity sensor goes inside with a little plastic piece to keep it centered. Once everything is laying nice and flush, you can go ahead and replace the speaker and then take the front facing camera cable and wrap it around, making sure that that goes inside of the plastic dust cover on the right hand side. And then we can replace the retaining panel and the 5 screws. This is a little bit like tying your shoe, so you've got to kind of hold everything in place while you get this metal panel back on. It does take a bit of practice, but make sure that all of these screws go back into their respective holes. From here, we're going to remove all of the residual adhesive that was left on the frame, so we want to have a nice clean surface to work with before we apply our new adhesive. From here, we'll peel off the bottom layer of plastic. And be careful not to touch the sticky stuff. If you do, it will not be as sticky as it was before you started. The fun part here is now. We have to align this thing perfectly, and you only get one shot at it, so I recommend that you buy a few of these if you don't have quite a bit of practice with installing them. It usually takes me at least once or twice to get this thing lined up straight, so I wouldn't recommend just buying one because it's too easy for these to go wrong. Once you have it stuck down, we're just going to go around the perimeter and make sure it adheres to the frame before we slowly remove this upper piece of plastic. There is a third piece that goes around the edges, so there's nothing sticky right now where I'm touching. All I'm doing is peeling off this layer, and it's nice the way that they make these because you've got a piece that goes around the edges, so nothing's going to stick onto the phone until we go ahead and remove that. Now that we've got the plastic off, we can go ahead and plug our screen back in. I like to start here at the top in this position. I find this the easiest way to reconnect the camera, and then we can spin the phone around and plug in our remaining 2 cables, and then of course make sure that you do connect the battery last. Put those retaining panels back into place, and we'll put our 2 Y000 and 4 PH000 screws back into the panels. From here, we have one last piece of plastic to remove. I recommend you take your time. I am going to speed up the camera to get through this, but the slower you go, the safer you'll be as far as not pulling the adhesive off of the frame. If that happens, you're probably going to have to go back and reinstall it, and that's what we want to avoid. Once you've got it all off, we want to make sure there's a gap at the top so that we can get our latches down inside, and then we can work around the edges and get the display fully installed onto the housing. From here, we just have to work our way around, make sure everything is sitting nice and flush, and if it looks like this, you did the job right, it is time to get the last 2 pentalobe screws into the bottom and power it up. And there we have a functional iPhone 8 Plus screen, as close to being as water resistant as it was from the factory as possible. If you found the video helpful, be sure to hit the like button, subscribe, and check out our weekly Tech Talk live stream. Have a great one, and thanks for watching.